Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with the empties from the month of May. So I don't have too many empties this month, but I will start with skincare because that's what I have the most of. And these first two items are from my spring project pan. So if you haven't seen that, I will link it up in the cards. But the first item is the Origins Drink Up Intensive Overnight Mask. I had this in my collection for a really, really long time, which is why I wanted to use it up. I think this is my second or third one of these, and I used to really, really love it, and it still is quite a good overnight moisturizer. I basically use this as moisturizers, not every day, but yeah, I could easily use this like every other day. But yeah, I basically used it up, and you can see from my pan, that's where I started. But recently I found things that I like more than this, so I probably won't repurchase this, but it is really, really good. And the scent of this is just so nostalgic to me because, like I said, I had this tube before and I used it for so many years, and this just brings back some memories. But I don't think I will repurchase this because, like I said, I found better things. The next item from my spring project pan is this one right here, and this is the Lancome Energy Divi, which is a smoothing and glow boosting serum. I bought this in a 50ml bottle at tax free, and it was good, but I don't feel like I saw any massive difference in my skin after using this, especially now when using it in the project, because I started using it more consistent that way. And I don't really see any major difference in my skin, so I don't think I will repurchase this because of the price. And I feel like you can get more targeted skincare that is better at this price, so I don't think I will repurchase this. But I heard other people really, really liking this, so perhaps it would work for you, but I just don't feel like this is worth the money for me. So moving from something that was quite expensive to something that is really, really cheap, and that is from The Ordinary, and this is the AHA 30% plus BHA 2% peeling solution. Yeah, just use a tiny bit there, but you can see this is like a bright red color, and this is basically just like a peeling mask, and this is definitely the best chemical exfoliant that I ever tried. I love this stuff. I already have a second bottle of this, and I feel like when I use this maybe once a week, sometimes twice depending on my skin, but since starting doing that, my skin has improved so much. It's so much smoother now, and I really can tell the difference when I use this. I stopped using this for a little bit because I was running out, and I didn't want to run out before I got a replacement, and I could definitely feel my skin getting more rough again, so I'm on to using my second bottle already. And yeah, I definitely recommend this stuff, and it is just so good, especially considering the price. So the last skincare product is just this cream right here. This is a prescription tretinoin cream. I get this from my dermatologist, and yeah, I use this up. This is just, I think this is a 0.25 mg tretinoin. This is one of the things that changed my skin most of all. I've been using this consistently for about maybe 9 months now, and my skin has improved so, so much. Tretinoin, if you don't know, is a type of retinol, and that's also really good with anti-aging from what I heard. I haven't used this too long to kind of see if it helps with anti-aging, and also I'm still quite young, so, but for me this has just really helped with the texture of my skin. And if you can get some type of retinol or tretinoin cream from prescription, I would really, really recommend it because it has changed my skin completely. And otherwise I would just try picking up some retinol products from the drugstore or from your pharmacist that aren't on prescription, because yeah, retinol is one of the best ingredients for anti-aging, and I definitely recommend those types of products. So this time around I actually don't have a full-size Batiste dry shampoo, which I always usually have, but I do have 2 minutes. I ran out of my big bottle of dry shampoo last month, and I featured that in my empties, and when I was going to pick a new one up, I found that my closest shop actually stopped selling Batiste, so I didn't actually go and pick it up, so I actually just used my minis up. But since then I picked up some other ones. I don't have to go too far to pick some up, but it's just that the shop that is closest to me, where I always pick them up normally, didn't have them anymore. So yeah, I used up these two as they were laying around. They are really good sizes for your handbag, So I definitely recommend these. These are not as good value for money as the big ones, obviously. So I have since then picked up more of my regular size Batiste. I actually have one perfume in my empties this month, and that is this one from Britney Spears. I think this is the Midnight Fantasy. You guys, this I probably had this for about 10 years. I bought this before I started high school, and I just didn't use it up. I honestly hadn't used this for about probably 5 years, and I just had a tiny bit, so I just decided to finish it off. This is for me quite a young smell. The scent is nothing that I would really gravitate towards anymore. It's not bad in any way, but it just reminds me of like being young, and yeah, I picked this up when I was about 15, so for me it just reminds me of being that young. And yeah, it is a nice scent, but it's definitely nothing that I will pick up again. So next item I have is this one from Macadamia. This is the Deep Repair Mask. This is a cool classic. I really, really love this stuff. The scent of this is so nice. Yeah, it really, really helps my hair. And I think this is pretty decently priced for what it does. It's not the most expensive hair mask, but it's not the cheapest either, and I feel like this helps so much more than, for example, like the really cheap ones from the drugstore. So I would definitely pick this up again in the future. I do have quite a few like mini jars of the conditioner, because I bought like a set from Sephora a couple years back, and I want to use those like smaller tubs up first before we purchase a big one. And I do have quite a lot of other hair care stocked up, so I will go through that and see if I have any more deep conditioning masks before I pick this up again. But it's definitely something I will pick up in the future. So I have two more items, and they're both from different projects. And the first one is a nail polish from My Project Polish, and this one is the Butter London nail polish in the shade Disco Biscuit. This was just a really, really lovely shade, with like pink shade with blue reflex in it. If you haven't seen my project polish, I'll link it up in the cards, and then you can see it on my swatch reel as well. But I used this up and it was a really, really nice shade, but I'm really happy to have it out of my collection. And then the last item for my empties for this month is a makeup item, and that is my Bobbi Brown Creamy Corrector in the shade Light Bisque. I used this up in my project pan, and you can see that it's completely empty. I really, really like this stuff. I actually put it into the project because I didn't reach for it and I didn't feel like it was an essential, but since actually finishing it, I've really started missing this. I do have a lot of one of these in the shade Light Peach, I think. Which is a bit darker than this, and not this. That's more obviously peach, and this is more pink. So I will use that up now, as soon as I'm starting to get more of a tan, because that suits me better in the summertime. And once I'm done with using up that corrector as well, I may repurchase this one or something similar in the future. Because although before I said that using a corrector wasn't really an essential for me, like I said, since starting using this, I really, really started enjoying the effect that it gave to my under eyes. So those were all the items in my empties this month. And like I said, I don't have too many empties this month, but if you haven't seen my previous ones, I will link it up in the cards, and you can see some other items that I used up this year. But I really hope you're having an amazing day, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye guys!